This pastor says, if you're not Baptist, get out. Let's watch.
This church is not a free-for-all. This isn't an open mic. This isn't a karaoke bar. Okay? I'm the man of God here. I meet the qualifications. I run this church. And if you don't like it, then get out. This is a New Testament church. We have a bishop here. Okay. We have an overseer here. Like it or lump it. And if you don't like it, feel free to get up and leave the service at any time. And if you're one of these oneness people, why don't you have the guts? Why don't you have the courage to get up and leave right now? Huh? Have the gall and the courage to come and face us and tell us. Instead of being like Dominique who texts us. After he sat, you all heard him sit in the front row of this church yelling amen every time I preach about the Trinity. Go back on YouTube. Watch all the YouTube videos. And what's he doing? He's sitting in the front row yelling amen. And now he's telling people, oh, I never really fully agreed on the Trinity. Then why'd you yell amen every time I talked about it and every time I preached against oneness? I'll tell you why. Because he's a hypocrite. That's why. People are hypocrites who like to sit in the front row and say amen loudly even though they don't even believe in it. That's called being a hypocrite. And then it's like they're yelling amen one day, and then 2 days later it's like, oh, I got to leave the church because I don't believe in the Trinity. You say, I'm not comfortable with this. Then just take a hike. Go take a hike. You know what? You ought to be thankful that you have a pastor who stands on Bible doctrine and doesn't care what people say. And I don't care if 90% of people get up and walk out or 50% of people walk out.
Okay.
I don't care. Because you know what? I'm not going to pastor a oneness cult. Amen. I'm not going to pastor a Pentecostal church.
Just
I'm the pastor
cult.
Of a Baptist church. Amen. And if you're not a Baptist, then get out.
Wow. Okay. So let's just dissect that just for a minute. This is... We're just going to react to this. Obviously, this guy is fired up about something. Apparently, Dominique has caused some trouble in the church. He's sending texts about how he don't believe in the Trinity. He's a oneness guy. And so he said basically, if you don't like it, get out. If you don't like what I preach, get out. You know, I don't have a problem with that expression or that thought at all. I mean, if you don't like what's going on, if you don't like what somebody's preaching in church, like, just get out. Like, there's other churches. You can find a different church. I think he's a little harsh. I think he's coming across a little rough with this. I think he's taken one incident with Dominique, and now it's become a whole church issue. But let's look at it real quick. He said, I am not going to pastor a oneness Pentecostal cult. Oneness Pentecostal cult. And I have to say this for people out there that don't know. I have to say this. Not all Pentecostals believe in oneness. As a matter of fact, every Pentecostal that I personally know and have had conversations with, they all believe in the Trinity. I don't know where this is coming from. Maybe there's one group. Maybe there's one teaching in one group, but you cannot label every Pentecostal. And this is the second time, as a matter of fact, that I've actually heard this, Pentecostal and oneness, that it's all Pentecostals. I need to stop you there and say that I believe in the Trinity wholeheartedly because I believe in the Word of God. So there's that. So not every Pentecostal is a oneness. And if you're wondering what oneness is, just look it up. It's really, they don't believe in the separate persons of the Trinity. They believe that God shows up in just one form to different people in different ways. But nonetheless, all right. So my question is, he says, if you're not a Baptist, then get out. Now, I do have a problem with this, and I find this a lot, John. Especially around where we are in the area that we're in. People are very allegiant to a denomination, and I find trouble with that. If I ask, you know, what is your faith or what do you believe in, and they say, you know, I'm blah, 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 insert the denomination name there. Now, if I name any denomination, somebody out there is going to be offended at me, but it's just the truth, you know. It's like, well, what do you believe? Well, you know, I'm Baptist, or you know, I'm Methodist, or, you know, yeah, very few Pentecostals actually say they're Pentecostals. They, you know, that from my experience, you know, because there's, you know, get that, oh, you're Pentecostal, you're weird. No, we're actually the same people, actually. We believe in the full gospel. So, but whatever your denomination is, that should not be the calling card in which you stand by, okay? So, if you, I feel like this guy's more Baptist than he is anything else. And so, we need to actually abandon our allegiance to denominations, because denominations simply are division. And we need to come together under one name and one banner, and that's Jesus Christ. And so the other part is, if you don't like what's happening in a church, should you stay or go? I believe you should leave. At that point in the service, if he said, if you're not Baptist, get up and leave, that's when I would get up and leave, because I do not identify as a Baptist. But I have to say this. This man has every right to say, if he's the pastor of this church, he has every right to say whatever he wants and do what he wants. Now, whether it's right or wrong, he is still in leadership at this church. And this is where people are going to have to, you know, Philippians 2:12, work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. Work out your own salvation, fear and trembling. If you don't agree, you know, it's not your job to come at this pastor and say you're the worst person ever. You know what? You don't have to support that church, and you don't have to give to that church, and you don't have to attend that church. This is a free expression. Unless this is a cult, then a cult is you can't leave. A cult won't let you leave. They'll lock the door and keep you there. Okay, and they'll tell you they're the only ones that have truth. They're the only one that can help you get to heaven. They're the only ones that have the right interpretation of the Bible, which I don't know that about this gentleman, this pastor, but I can tell you we need more people who are more convicted by the Word of God than they are their church denomination. God bless you guys. I hope this blessed you. Tune in more. KTF Podcast. You can go to ktfpodcast.com. You can watch us on all the platforms. We hope to see you soon. God bless you. Keep the faith all the way to the finish line.